How did the giraffe get its long neck? Characterized by its long legs, long neck, and distinctive spotted pattern, many people first believed the giraffe was a cross between a leopard and a camel, which is reflected in its scientific name, Giraffe camelopardalis. Giraffes live primarily in savanna areas in the sub-Saharan region of Africa. Their extreme height allows them to eat leaves and shoots located much higher than other animals can reach. In particular, they seek out acacia trees. Their long tongues are helpful in eating because they help pull leaves from the trees. Spending most of the day eating, a full-grown giraffe consumes over 45 kilograms of leaves and twigs a day. Around 15 million years ago, antelope-like animals were roaming the dry grasslands of Africa. There was nothing very special about them, but some of their necks were a bit long. Within a mere 6 million years, they had evolved into animals that looked like modern giraffes, though the modern species only turned up around 1 million years ago. The tallest living land animal, a giraffe stands between 4.5 and 5 meters tall, and almost half that height is neck. Most people assume that giraffes' long necks evolved to help them feed. If you have a long neck, runs the argument, you can eat leaves on tall trees that your rivals can't reach. But there is another possibility. The prodigious necks may have little to do with food and everything to do with sex. The evidence supporting the high feeding theory is surprisingly weak. Giraffes in South Africa do spend a lot of time browsing for food high up in trees, but elsewhere in Africa they don't seem to bother, even when food is scarce. Giraffes' necks are long, but there have been longer ones. Sauropod dinosaurs trump them easily. The dinosaur Mamenchisaurus, for instance, had a neck over 9 meters long, four times the longest of giraffe necks. Long necks come at a cost. Because a giraffe's brain is around 2 meters above its heart, the heart has to be big and powerful. In fact, for the blood to reach the brain, it has to be pumped at the highest pressure of any animal. So there must be a big payback to keep giraffes' necks so long. The latest theory, and it's a surprise this hasn't come up before, given biologists' fixation with it, is that the long necks are the results of sexual selection. That is, they evolved in males as a way of competing for females. Male giraffes fight for females by necking. They stand side by side and swing the backs of their heads into each other's ribs and legs. To help with this, their skulls are unusually thick and they have horn-like growths called ossicones on the tops of their heads. Their heads, in short, are battering rams and are quite capable of breaking their opponent's bones. Having a long and powerful neck would be an advantage in these duels, and it's been found that males with long necks tend to win, and also that females prefer them. The necks for sex idea also helps explain why giraffes have extended their necks so much more than their legs. If giraffes evolved to reach higher branches, we might expect their legs to have lengthened as fast as their necks, but they haven't. That's all for today. Thank you so much for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button.